everyone, it's Carolyn, and welcome back to Contemporary Mama. Today's video is another episode in my monthly decluttering series. If you are new, then I have been taking you along on decluttering my house for almost the past year. Today, we are going to be tackling three areas, so let's head right on into it.
So I'm starting with my dresser. Looks pretty normal, except you can already see that my drawers are like busting open. So they are like totally stuffed to the brim in some drawers, and then some of them, I don't even know what's going on in here, just like random things. So I'm gonna totally reorganize them after I get this all decluttered. So the first step is always clearing everything out. Once I got my entire dresser emptied out, I'm gonna go ahead and sort through my clothes. There were quite a few pieces that I decided to donate, and then I'm just gonna fold everything really nicely into piles before I put it back in the dresser, nice and organized. For those of you that didn't know, I'm a nurse and I do wear scrubs to work. However, since I work part-time, I don't need that many. So instead of taking up an entire drawer, I decided to fold them really small, and I'm gonna put them in one of these Dollar Tree basket organizers that I bought recently. I did a huge declutter of my closet back in March, so I have plenty of room to store this in there. I decided not to go through my bras and underwear on camera. I was a little bit embarrassed to do that, but I am just going through my sock pile here, and I have a bunch of different kinds. I have like low-cut white athletic socks, I have wool socks for the winter, and then I also have compression stockings that I wear to work. So I'm just going through those, making sure that every sock has a match, and if they don't, then it is getting the boot. I had bought a bunch of these reusable plastic bags recently, so I thought that these would be really good for storing all of my tights in, because those seem to get tangled up all the time, and it worked absolutely perfectly. I have one of these for my tights and the other one for these teeny tiny non-slip socks or no-show socks. Those always seem to get lost in my sock drawer, so those will keep those nice and tidy, and then I won't have to go searching for them when I need them. I bought these drawer organizers from Aldi a while back, and unfortunately they did not fit in my drawers, so I was super bummed about that, but I perhaps will buy some in the future on Amazon. But I'm still really pleased with how my drawers came out. I think just sorting everything and giving my socks a different drawer than my underwear, it was really gonna help keep it organized, because I used to have everything in one big drawer or in one drawer, and it was just a nightmare. So now everything has plenty of room, and I think it's just gonna stay a lot more organized even without those drawer organizers. Need you here to feel good. No, I'm not angry. I got better things to do. Tell your friends I will be just fine. Don't need no therapist. There's nothing like wine. So once I have everything nice and organized in my drawer, I can go ahead and place my scrubs in this little basket, and wouldn't you know, they fit absolutely perfect. And then lastly over here is this little pile of clothes that I'm going to fold up and put away for when I have a donation pickup. Moving on to project number two, I'm going to be going through my kids' books, and we are so blessed that they have so many, but we have actually maxed out on capacity on both of the bookshelves in each of their rooms. and they always get books for presents for their birthdays and Christmas, so I want to make sure that we clear out the ones that we no longer need. Now, my youngest is 2.5, so I really wanted to get rid of kind of like the baby books, the ones that don't have any words, because she is more than capable of following along with a storybook, so we really don't use those anymore. And another thing I wanted to get rid of are books that were damaged. My kids, when they were younger, loved to kind of like tear apart those pop-up books. So we have so many of them that have all the pop-ups torn out. So they're pretty much useless, and it was time to recycle those. So here's the pile of books that I was able to clear off of my daughter's bookcase. And as you can see, an entire shelf is now cleared off, so we have plenty of room for new books. So now I'll just be repeating the process in my son's room of going through all of his books. And I'm actually going to be doing this with him. I love decluttering with my son. He's pretty savage when it comes to it. He has no problem admitting when he doesn't use something, and he loves the fact that we are going to be donating it to kids in need. So I cleared off a whole shelf on the bookcase, which is great. We can store something else there and we'll have plenty of room for new books. And then I have this big shopping bag pretty much filled with all the baby books that we no longer need. I found someone in my town who could really use them, and she is coming to pick them up tomorrow. My glass was always half empty. The last project that I want to tackle today is this cabinet that we have in our hall bathroom. It just becomes kind of like a free-for-all. We store a ton of different things in here. And what I really, really wanted to do is go through all of our medications. I have them stored by category in these plastic bins. And I really haven't gone through them thoroughly in quite some time. So I really wanted to clear everything out and especially go through those because I don't want to have any old expired medications just hanging around our house. So that took up the most time. It probably took me well over 10 minutes to go through all of those medications and weed out the ones that we no longer need. But I'm so happy that I did because I would say at least 50% of them were expired. So I'm going to be taking those to be disposed of. If you need some guidance about where to dispose of old expired medications, reach out to your local pharmacy. They're a great resource and they can definitely point you in the right direction. I got through all the medications that pretty much handled all of the decluttering. Besides a few empty cleaning containers, I didn't really get rid of much else. So I'm just going through and kind of organizing everything back into the cabinet. As you can see, I folded up some of my kids' washcloths, and then I'm just putting those bins of medications back in there after I organize all of my cleaning supplies and a few extra random things. I want to thank you all so much for watching. I hope that this video gave you some motivation to tackle an area of your house that is in desperate need of some organizing and decluttering. I'm going to see you guys on Friday with another brand new video. Bye!